to spread through Great Britain, many people thought the government's policy was to just let the virus spread until people became immune through herd immunity. But actually, the British government was simply overly optimistic about how easy it would be to flatten the curve. So Cheryl's asking this question, and she wants details on this. Her question, what is herd immunity and how does it work?
Well, this is one of the biggest questions people ask me on the street. So Cheryl, herd immunity happens when so many people in a community actually become immune to an infectious disease, and that it stops the disease from spreading at that point. This can happen in a couple of ways. Many people will contract the disease, and in time, it will build up an immune system in the entire population. So that would be what we call natural immunity. Or many people are vaccinated against the disease, and that will also achieve immunity. For some diseases, herd immunity can go into effect when about 40% of the people in the population become immune to the disease, such as through vaccination. But in most cases, 80 to 95% of the population must be immune to the disease to stop its spread. So it's called herd for a reason. It's called herd because we have to act like it's a full herd of cattle or a full herd of people that are infected and actually get cured or get a vaccine. There's no vaccine right now, so what we don't want is for people to all get sick at one time. So, once again, physical distance.